2 epsilon minus 5 divided by epsilon. This element will become 0. Why it is 0? If I calculate this one minus this one into this one minus this one into this one divided by this one. So 0, zeros into 0. So it will become 0. It will become 0. Next, this element is 5. How it is 5? This element will come here. Why it is coming? This one into this one minus this one into this one. So this one into this one is equal to 0. So this one into this one divided by this one. So after divisioning, that means after cancellation of this term, we will get this 5 here, and this is 0, this is 0. From this, we can, after calculating this first column of the array by replacing 0 with epsilon, now you substitute the value of epsilon here. Epsilon is equal to 0. You substitute the value of 0 instead of epsilon here. So it is 0, no problem with this. And next, 2 into 0, it is 0 minus 5 divided by 0. So minus 5 divided by 0. So that is minus 5 divided by 0. This will become minus 5 divided by 0 is equal to minus infinity. That means it is a negative sign, it is a positive sign, and it is a negative sign. Again, it is a positive sign, plus 5 it is. So it is a positive. So it is positive, it is negative, it is positive. So there are two sign changes here, from positive to negative, one sign change, from negative to positive, another sign change. So two sign changes here. So the system is unstable system. The system is unstable system with two poles in the right half of the S-plane. Two poles in the right half of the S-plane. Okay. Next, another solution. If the first column, if one element in the first column is equal to 0, then by making that 0 is equal to epsilon is the one solution. Another solution here is by making S is equal to 1 by Z. Here in this characteristic equation, if we put S is equal to 1 by Z, then this characteristic equation will become like this. 1 by Z power 4 plus 1 by, here it is S cube. So 1 by Z cube plus 2 by Z square plus 2 by Z plus 5 is equal to 0. And after taking the LCM as a Z power 4 here, then we will get the, this is the new characteristic equation. So you find the stability, or you form the Routh array. You form the Routh array for this characteristic equation and find the stability for this characteristic equation, as we discussed already, like this. So if that if this characteristic equation will gives in the first column of the Routh array, if all the elements are positive for this characteristic equation, then the system is stable. This system is stable. If the first column of the Routh array consists of any element in the first column is negative, then the system is unstable. Like that, we can calculate for this type of case. That means if any one element in the first column of Routh array becomes 0. Next case, next special case here is case 2. If any one row in the Routh array is 0, that means if the total row, here you see this is the total row, becomes 0 here for this type of characteristic equation. Suppose I am forming a Routh array for this characteristic equation, S power 6 plus S power 5 plus 5 S power 4 plus 3 S cube plus 2 S square minus 4 S minus 8 is equal to 0. So S power 6, S power 5, S power 4, S cube, S square, S power 1, S power 0. Okay. It is 1. The quotient of S power 6 is 1. Leave one term 5. Leave one term 2. Leave one term minus 8. Next, S power 5 coefficient is 1. Leave one term 3. Leave one term minus 4. Next one is 0. And after that, you calculate 1 into 5. 5 minus 3. 5 minus 3 is equal to 2. 2 by 1. So this element is 2. And next, 1 into 2. 2 minus 4 into 1. So 2 plus 4 divided by 1. That is equal to 6. This element, 1 into minus 8. Minus 0 into 1. So this will become minus 8 here. Okay, this is 0. Next, 2 into 3, 6, 6 minus 6, 0, 2 into minus 4, minus 8 into 1, minus 8, so minus 8 plus 8 will become 0 here. Again, these two are zeros. That means the total row, the complete total row will become zeros here. So whenever this type of situation arises, what we have to do here is we need to form an auxiliary equation. This auxiliary equation coefficients can be find out just above this row. Just above this row coefficient, that means a power s, this is a even polynomial, s power 4 coefficient is 2s power 4, here it is 2s power 4 plus 6s square minus 8 is equal to 0. And here if I differentiate this auxiliary equation dA of s divided by ds, that is equal to 8s cube plus 12s. Here the coefficient of this coefficients are 8 and 12. Just you substitute here 8, the s cube coefficient here is 8 and 12, remaining all are zeros here. Then you can proceed the remaining procedure as we discussed earlier. Next, 8 into 6 is 48 minus 12 into 2, 24 divided by 8. So what is this value? 48 minus 24, this is 24 divided by 8, so this will become plus 3. Next, 8 into minus 8, minus 0 into 2, 0 divided by 8, so this will become minus 8, the remaining all are zeros here. So this is 3, this total element is 3 and it is minus 8, 0, 0. Next, to calculate this element, again you multiply these two, 12 threes, 36, minus of minus, that is minus 8 into 8, so it is minus 64 divided by 3. So this element, 8 into 0, 0, so this is 0. Next, what is this? This one is, it is a positive element, 36 plus 64, it is 100 divided by 3, that is 33.33, it is 33.33. Next, 33.33 into minus 8, minus 0 into 3 divided by 33.33, so this element will become minus 8. Here, if we observe the first column of this Routh array, here there is a, it is 33.33, it is 33.33, it is minus 8, so it is a positive, it is a positive, here also it is positive, it is negative here, but here it is negative, here it is positive, it is also positive, positive, positive here. So there is only one sign change here, there is only one sign change, okay, there is only one sign change, that means there is only one pole that is located in the, one pole that is located, located in the right half of the S plane, and the system is, and the system is unstable system, and the system is unstable system, unstable system. And also some of the poles are located in the imaginary axis, that means some of the poles are located in the imaginary axis, and the location of these poles can be found out by using this auxiliary equation, by making this auxiliary equation is equal to 0, 2s power 4, that is 2s power 4 plus 6s square minus 8 is equal to 0, then we will get the values as s is equal to 4 roots, we get 4 roots here, 4 roots, among these 4 roots, 4 roots are located here, it is like this. So 4 roots are located in this imaginary axis. So remaining here 6 roots, the characteristic equation consists of 6 roots here. In this 6 roots, 4 roots, 4 roots on the, 4 roots on the imaginary axis, imaginary axis, 1 root on the, 1 root is on the right half of the S plane, and remaining 1 root on the is on left half of the S plane. So this is the information about the this characteristic equation.